Welcome to It's a High Raw Life, episode 12. Simple lunch today. I cut open a cantaloupe. It was in the fridge, I have to use it. And then I also have sprouts in the fridge, and so I just made a hand roll. I think that's what they call it in the Japanese restaurants. Some sprouts, I spread a little tahini and some of my organic soy sauce on it, stuck in some scallions and ginger, that's it. So that's lunch in a few minutes. Put that over here. So I had a couple questions about sprouting. I've mentioned it before, so I wanted to show you some of my fun sprout stuff. But also, you don't need anything special to sprout with. You could sprout with anything, a jar, all kinds of stuff. There's 5 million websites all about sprouting. But for my birthday last year, I asked for this little kitchen double sprouting tray. I was excited. It came with a sprouting book. So I got it. Want to see what's in here? Okay, I'll show you because I'm excited. I'm sprouting some more peas. Do you remember I sprouted peas several episodes ago? They were so good, and I let them sprout until they get a little green on them, and then I had a couple of them just sitting in a glass of water, and they were starting to really grow, and I just thought, oh, I'm going to plant them. And then one day, one of the kids was just bored and picked it apart. I don't know why, but so I'm sprouting some more, and I think I might have let them sprout a little too long. You can start eating these right now. I think you could just eat them at any point. But I'm going to let them go just a tiny bit. Underneath there in the second wrap, I have mung beans going. So these also, I've mentioned before, they don't get big, long, fat, juicy tails on them when you make them at home. And again, not really sure why. But let's see if I can show you how these are going. I don't know. Can you see that? Oops, drop one. See, they get their little tail. The little green shell comes off. So this is one of my sprouts, a double tray. Sometimes I just use a single. And really, I have tried the mung beans in a couple of different things, and I haven't decided which one's the best. But for alfalfa sprouts, which are so easy to grow, I made such an abundance of them last time, so I'm still eating those. Some other things you can sprout in is you can sprout in what's called a nut milk bag or a sprout bag. This one is nylon. They sell them in hemp. You know what I was thinking? Since it's nylon, couldn't you use a pair of like really cheap pantyhose or knee highs? Just wash it really well? Maybe that's toxic and poison. I don't know. But if you're in a pinch and you just want to try it, I'll just wash one out and try that. So after you soak your seeds and put them in, you just let this hang. I don't love this method because then I've got this bag hanging, and you know, I don't know, not fun. Then this other thing I have is, I'm not selling anything, so you have to look for this stuff yourself if you want it, but it's just a sprout container, and it can sit on top so that the water can drain out on the bottom, makes it easy. I like that one too. But here's what I just came up with. You know, I live in a mixed household, meaning I'm high raw. Hubby's not high raw. He's low raw, but he's getting there a little bit at a time. But he recently ate some microwave meal that came in this tray. This is what it looked like, the steaming tray or something. And I looked at it, said, I gotta wash that out. I can sprout in that because this has holes, okay, just like this has holes, you know. And then it has little feet that keep it from touching the bottom. So I'm going to do an experiment for you guys. I'm going to sprout in here. And then he had two, not one day, but I saved the bottom of another one because then it could be like a lid. So look at that. Ask your friends and neighbors if anyone eats these meals that you make in a microwave that come with two trays. I don't know what they're called. I can't tell you. But you can sprout in that for sure. I'm definitely going to try that. So I was thinking about the price of the produce, and it's freezing here in New Jersey, and I am doing a little indoor garden. Over the summer, I had a garden. I was a little successful. Not hugely successful, but it was just more than I could handle. It was practically a farm. This is more my side. So I'm going to see what happens. I've got some spinach, radishes. I just put a couple of those peas in. This stick is to be a natural trellis for the peas. because I have great expectations. They're going to shoot up. And then some jalapeno peppers and cilantro. We'll see what happens. It's cold out, but I know people do indoor gardening wherever they live, and I figure, you know, if I have to be here in the winter, I may as well try it. If I have a really cold week, I think what I'll do is put a heating pad, the regular kind you plug in, and just sit this on top of it for a little while. This was great. It was like $6, I think, at Walmart. I didn't have to buy seeds because I had organic seeds left over from the summer. So I don't know where you would get seeds from now. I bet any garden store that would have them, probably even just any store that carries seeds regularly would have them now somewhere in the corner. And I bought a little bag of organic potting mix for potted vegetables and stuff. So there you go, a few bucks, not too much. We'll see what happens, it'll be fun. I think it's going to help me cheer up because, I don't know, I'm cold. I'm annoyed with being cold all the time. Anyway, that's it for today. I'm going to have my very simple lunch of simple sprouts and a cantaloupe right now. And if I get hungry later, I'll have something else. And that's all. Thanks for watching today on It's a High Raw Life. See you next time.